So once you have your hdri set up in Blender like we do here, one thing that you might want to do is actually rotate this environment. So for example, we have our sun in this direction, but maybe we want it over here instead. So to rotate the hdri, go over to shading, go over to world, and here we have our hdri fed into our world output surface. And what we want to do is put some nodes over here that will basically rotate this texture. So to do this, click Shift A, go to vector, and then go over to mapping. And we're going to attach these two. This is where we're going to put our instructions for rotation. But we need to feed in some texture coordinates. So we're going to click Shift A again, input, texture coordinates. And then we're just going to connect these two using the generated texture coordinates. And then let's open up rendered view. Nothing happened yet, but that's because we didn't actually do any rotation. So you can just drag these values over here, and you can see it's beginning to rotate. I'll do it some more. We can actually rotate it on this axis or on this axis. And since we're using cycles, it will always take a bit to update. But if you want to see this happen faster and you're using 2.8, one thing you might want to do, enable Eevee, and it will take a second to load. We have Eevee enabled, and now we can do our rotations with no latency, very fast. And then when you're happy with what you have, just go back over to cycles and you have successfully rotated. So again, just to recap, we have our HDRI. We're going to manipulate it with this mapping node where we can put in our rotation values. And of course, we're going to have to feed in some texture coordinates so we know what it is that we're rotating. So hopefully this helped, and thank you guys for watching.